So, and you're on entry level. Representative, so much you some minutes back.
8 minutes.
You faked it really well.
Yeah, faked it.
Perfect. Okay, so no systems. No systems. What system do you need, Joseph?
I haven't done it yet.
Awesome. Well, not awesome, actually.
Yeah,
but
not awesome.
You need 8 steps
and guard.
On guard theory? Cool. What system do would y'all value the most?
Fuji.
Y'all value Fuji the most?
Yeah.
Okay, let's do Fuji. Alright, I might do all of them now.
Why not?
Okay, Fuji. Right, who was I talking to yesterday about Fuji? Yes, Habibi. I was talking to Habibi and I was telling him, hey, Fuji is a system to do what? Create impulse or create?
More impulse.
Create more impulse. Okay, this is a system to create more impulse. More impulse. Now, what is impulse?
Urgency.
Okay, urgency and what? Close. You're really close.
Assertiveness.
Okay, close. What else?
Action.
Okay, now put it together. What you just said, both answers.
The urgency
and action. Okay, because impulse. Who here is like buy stuff on impulse? Like Amazon, Amazon placed the add to cart and then the order now. How many of us go for the order now? Raise your hand. If your hand's down, you're lying. Okay, right. We love to buy things. We like to make a split decision. Agreed. That's impulse. Okay, it's to buy something right on the go. Okay, and then be like later being on like, did I really need that? Yeah, too late. Right, like, anyone ever buy something because it says like for the next 3 hours free shipping?
Yeah.
Who's acting on one of those sales? Okay, it builds your impulse. Okay, this is what Fuji does. Okay, Fuji will make you act on that impulse. And what I like to say is 5 steps to a conversation is a system to do what?
To build impulse.
Okay, so what I it's such a weird thing, but bear with me for the analogy. Okay, 5 steps are boneless wings. Okay, who likes wing? Who likes boneless wings and who likes bone-in? Boneless? Raise your hand. Bone-in? Raise your hand. Oh, it's like split even. Oh, this is like a good debate. Okay, cool. So whichever one you like, right? I consider 5 steps to a conversation the wing. Fuji is like that Wingstop ranch. Anyone like Wingstop ranch?
Yes.
Okay, cool. It's fire. it's like unhealthily really good. Okay, you only like, who like here just puts like tiny bit of ranch? One or two people? Okay, who here just like dunks that thing? Okay, so this is what Fuji is. You want to dunk the wing in the ranch. Your ranch is Fuji. Does that kind of make sense?
Mm-hmm.
Okay, so they should complement each other. Okay, but one has to come first. It's pretty weird to dip ranch in something that's not a wing. Okay, like the wing and then just dipping off fingers. It's weird. Okay, so you need the 5 steps first. Make sense? Okay, I know it's a weird analogy, but y'all understand what I was trying to say.
Yeah.
Cool. All right. The F in Fuji is for what?
Fear of loss.
Okay, why would we want to fear of loss our customer? Okay, no, what I'm hearing people do when they start teaching back the system is like they kind of make it like a deceiving thing. Okay, Fuji is not a lie. Understand that. Okay, everything we say in Fuji is a straight fact. Okay, because how many times do we switch territories every day?
Yeah.
So how many days are we going to be in front of the customer?
One.
What do we want to tell the customer?
We're only out here today.
Hey, I am only out here today. Okay, you want to create that fear of loss that, hey, I always like to say, you're the walking promotion. If you're in water, hey, you're a walking cheat code. What do you have to put in order for them to get the discount? Your badge code. You are a walking promo code. Okay? Right? They get the discounts when you have your iPad. Your iPad is a walking cheat code. Okay? So you are the walking promo. When you leave their door, what else leaves with them?
The
promotion. Okay? You want to create that idea and that image in their head. The way we want to do it is with some verbal things. Okay? What are some keywords we like to do to create fear of loss?
We're only available today.
Only today?
The promotion has once we leave.
And limited slots.
I always say limited slots. Okay, because is that true? Are there limited slots?
Yes.
Yes. Hey, what are some other things you, people say to create fear of loss?
While there are notes still left.
Okay, I would like to say, like, while availability. Like, while availability is still open. Or limited availability. Okay? Anything you want to do, you want to say this 3 times every email. Okay? I'm telling my person, hey, only today, they put up these towers that get all your neighbors 5 times the faster service for a fraction of the cost. So really quick, before I have to leave, okay, before I head out, I just got to show you. Okay? The next one is?
Urgency.
Urgency. Why would we want to be urgent? And who's got stuck with that customer who will talk your ear off? Raise your hand. Okay, why do we remember that customer? Reason why is because we're counting how much money we're losing because we're spending time with person X who likes to talk about bingo night for 3 hours. Okay, right? Do we want to be urgent at every single time? Okay, are we making money in between doors?
No.
So do we want to cut the? Do we want to make the time between doors long or short?
Short.
Short. Okay. Do we want to be urgent in the way we move and in the way we talk? So we have nonverbal and verbal cues. Okay. Nonverbal. What can we do to create urgency?
Foot tapping. Okay. Looking at the iPad.
Okay. I always look at the iPad. Or a clipboard.
I'm looking at your watch.
Okay, I really do look at my watch a lot.
Fake phone call. That I saw the other day, it was nice.
Okay, what he's talking about is if you know you're gonna get stuck with a customer, I always love to be like, oh, really quick, I gotta check in with my boss every 5 minutes. And I'll tell someone to call me and be like, hey, ask him for a rush or something. Okay, and you might think, if you ever run into that customer, you're gonna run into that customer.
Just make sure it is afterwards, because when I see somebody pick that up, I was like, no,
because
that's rude, but that's like...
After. This is for after. Anybody ever get stuck with the customer after the sale?
Yeah.
And they're like, hey, but before you go. And I'm like, bro, no. Right? And they're like, but. And I'm like, stop. Leave me alone, okay? It happens. Right? It means you're great at TPR, okay? But careful, okay? Because it can waste your whole day. Right, but you always look at watch. Yeah, I would say don't do it like don't be that guy. Okay, but I'm always like, yeah, so really quick, I just gotta show you this. Because I couple the action with the verbal cues. Okay, what are some things we say?
Really fast.
Really fast.
Real quick.
Super quick.
We're in a rush
again.
Really
minutes.
Quick. Super fast.
It only takes 2 minutes.
Okay, I would like to say last thing. I'm on the last email for 5 emails. Okay, I'm on the last part of the phone 6 times. Okay, and I'm like, hey, last thing we need is your email.
Remember that guy in the car?
Okay, yeah. Yeah, that guy that we were in the car, guy that I stopped in the car.
Yeah.
This guy was on his way to work, and I made him roll down his window. I was like, yeah, last thing we need is your social. And if you've done 5G, that's like the first thing you need.
Yeah, yeah. Saying, I'm like, I gotta go. Yeah, last thing, I gotta go. I was like, oh, man.
You clicked in? Come the other day. Good guy. Okay, really quick, super fast. Last thing, what else?
Takes no time.
Takes no time? Totally forgot about how to write. Okay, the other thing I like to say is before I head out. Okay, before I head out, I just grab your phone. Make sense? Cool. All right. Anything else we want to add to urgency?
Sometimes I say before I
have
my appointment with your husband,
you get rushed. Okay, cool. Before an appointment. Okay. Awesome. We'll leave that. And then let's head to G, which is what?
Greed.
Greed. Okay. What kind of, we just want to say we want to create something. What is it called? Jones effect. Does anybody know what Jones effect is?
Everyone wants what everyone has.
Everyone wants what everyone has. What I mean by that is look today, okay? If you're in your first couple of weeks, look for a Ring camera, okay? And then look for the next door neighbor. And tell me if they have a regular doorbell or do they have a Ring camera. It's so funny. It'll go from like Vivint to Kangaroo to Ring to Google Home. And it's like, they just start one-upping it. It's hilarious. And then the next one has a doorman. Okay, right, like that's how much they want to one-up each other. Okay, right, Jones effect is people want what everyone has. Especially, I don't know what it is, but a cul-de-sac, everyone knows everyone. Okay, this is why it's so important. I love to name drop. If you're not saying, hey, Joy across the street actually told me you would love this, right? Because if I talk to a customer and they're super talkative with me, do you think they're super talkative with their neighbors?
Yeah.
I'm name dropping anybody who talks the most. I'm like, hey, Joy, like just like I was telling Joy, and they're like, oh yeah, I know Joy. One time this lady was at one street, first store, first sale. Five streets later. And I'm like, yeah, so your neighbor, Karen? And she's like, what, you know her? And I'm like, bro, how do you know her? She's like, she talks to everyone. I'm like, she walks her dog the whole blocks. And I'm like, what do you mean? And then there she came. She's like, I knew she was gonna get it. And I was like, bro, go home, right? But if they're talking, think about it like this, it's very common sense. If your customer's talking a lot with you, a stranger who they didn't know 30 minutes ago, what do you think they're talking about with the person they live next to? They're talking, okay? So if you don't name drop, we're missing a huge opportunity to create a lot of belief, to create a lot of trust with that customer. Does that make sense?
Yeah.
Okay, does anyone have any questions on that? Right, the next thing is, as always, like, we like to talk about this picture. Okay, here's one house, and it has a pool, okay? Or a chimney, like a chimney. Okay, neighbor two has a two-story house and a slightly bigger pool, okay? What do you think the next neighbor has? They got the lake, right? They got the same two-story house, right? But they got a lake and they got a slide. Okay, and then he just keeps going and keeps going and keeps going. Right, anyone ever gotten that one customer that's like, wait, they bought it? Or anybody ever had a customer that's like, so is everybody getting it?
Literally yesterday.
Yeah. What do we always say?
Yeah.
Yup. And they're like, people are like, I don't think I mentioned, I'm like, I used to act like really surprised. I'm like, you're gonna be the, you don't, are you sure? Like your neighbors are all getting, and you'd be like, wait, hold on, what? Right, and they're like, even, and then they name drop somebody. You ever had a customer that name dropped somebody else? I'm like, bro, even her? Look, she's right here, you missed it. Okay, right, and so you always wanna name drop and you always wanna see, make sure they're inclusive. Okay, you wanna do inclusive terms. Right, do we ever say, I always say, instead of you, what should we say?
They.
Okay, or everyone?
All your neighbors.
Or all your neighbors. Okay, you wanna make it, I never say you. If you say you in your pitch, you are missing out on a huge opportunity. Okay? Yeah, you're missing out on a huge opportunity. Hey, for all your neighbors that are going through Wi-Fi issues, right? Anyone ever, have you ever read someone who was like, I hate Spectrum? Okay, what do you think their neighbors like? Are the same way?
Mm-hmm.
Same thing. Okay, you wanna make sure, hey, all your neighbors said the same thing. And they're like, wow, I feel for them. Okay, right, inclusive terms of they, everyone, all your neighbors, today only, right? Do another. Last one is?
Indifference.
Okay, you wanna, I always talk about sale from abundance. Okay, what I mean by that is you wanna help out the customer, but you don't need the customer. You wanna create that idea. Like, hey, I'm here, but I'm not gonna waste my time. So are we here, or are we doing this or not? Okay, so many of us, we have commission breath, right? Indifference and commission breath don't match. Okay, and nowhere on here does it say force a sale down someone's throat. Right, we're saying be smooth with it, right? We always talk about the Tommy Lee. Hey, this is kind of funny that we realize this, but y'all know Tommy's a real person?
Yes.
Did y'all know that? That's so funny. People talk about the Tommy. Who's heard of the Tommy Lee? Okay, who's met Tommy? That's so funny. Okay, Tommy was an assistant manager when I was an assistant manager in Rich's office. Okay, and this man, right, like, it's funny. He's the one that I said went through the training program with four daughters. Okay, this man would be at the door and he'd be like, so. And like leaned up, like a cute angle. Okay, right? And so we always thought we called it the Tommy Lean. Right? We love him to death. Right, what else do we want to do? We want to do the Tommy Lean. What else to create the indifference?
Shoulder shrug.
Panda pause. What else?
Step back.
Okay, step back. Drop three. Okay, what else? There's one more. I always like to say something. What I like to say, what does everyone should say?
If it's fine for you, it's good for you.
They just sent me out here?
Ryzen dot dot dot.
And then someone's like, hey, what's going on? What do we like to say?
Nothing crazy.
Nothing crazy. So many of us don't even know that's the difference because we just do it like the back of our hand. Okay, I'm saying it's nothing crazy like 10 times. If someone comes up to the door and they're like, what do you want? Hey, I'm like, hey bro, something crazy, they just sent me out here. I'm just doing my job. You ever get mad at the doorman for opening a door? No, right? Why would you mad at me? I'm just doing my job. Right? I do that a lot. I'm like, hey, it's nothing crazy, they just wanted me to let you know. And they're like, oh, I'm not interested. I didn't ask that. They want me to let you know that your Wi-Fi is getting better. You're welcome. What's a social? Right? And I do that a lot. I'm like, hey. And they're like, I'm so sorry, I'm just not interested. I'm like, hey, you don't gotta say sorry to me. They just told me to tell you. Grab your phone. Right? Every time. Who's been out in the field with me? Do I do this all the time? Random. So I'm super different. Okay? Now the thing I want to talk about is when to utilize it, okay? This is the problem I see. Is someone only uses urgency and they do zero fear of loss. Okay? The way to drench it, okay? The way to go ahead and get the best out of Fuji is to realize your audience. Okay, realize your audience. If a couple comes to the door, anyone ever had the husband and the wife come to the door? Raise your hand. Okay? Well, which one do you think is gonna be the best one? You think you wanna be indifferent? No, what system which one out of all of them would you use?
Fear of loss.
Fear of loss and?
Greed.
Hands down. Greed. Hey, all your neighbors. And they're like, one time I was like, hey, so what the other neighbors are doing, what the other couples are doing? And the wife's like, baby, did you watch the neighbors? And they're like, the husband's like, I don't think we're interested. And she's like, what do you mean the neighbors are getting it? And she's like, he's like, I guess we're getting it. And I'm like, I guess we are. I mean, I would. Right? And I'm sitting there, I'm like, only today though. And they're like, okay, let's do it. Right? And with that, if someone else opens my door, if I get a person in their 20s opening the door, do they really care about their neighbors?
No.
What would you practice more?
Indifference.
I'm like, hey, bro. They just got me out here, bro. I'm like, it's my first day. Right? Just grab your phone before you piss me off. Okay? Right? Like, I'm sitting there, and I'm using more indifference with someone my age. Couples, degree. Okay? If they're older, I'm doing a little bit more urgency. Like, hey, really quick, super fast. Don't talk to me, just give me your phone. Okay, I'll do everything. Right, make sense? Okay, right, the goal is to find out what to do more of. Make sense?
Does
anyone have any questions on any of this? Okay guys, teach it back like this. It is okay to go this in depth. Okay, you think that now, who's gonna use Fuji in their pitch? Who hasn't been using Fuji? Admit it, it's okay. Who's like, I could be doing way more fear of loss?
Yeah.
Okay, I'm talking about Bug called me on Monday or Tuesday. Right, Alicia called me on Tuesday. She's like, Danny, I'm losing my attitude. And I'm like, okay, let me hear your pitch. And she's like, no. And I'm like, okay. I was like, hey, record it and send it to me. I promise you, you probably just not doing a lot of Fuji. I was like, hey, say only today and right now, 5 times. I promise you, you will make a sale in the next 10 minutes. Do we make a sale? Did we qualify?
Yeah.
Right, she was at zero and it was what, 5:30? Around there. It was, she had no walking for free till 5:30. Calls me, I say, hey, just do Fuji. Qualifies and has qualified since then. And she's like, Danny, I love Fuji. And I'm like, hey, it's almost like a system. Okay. So you're not teaching it back to teach it back to get to leadership. You're teaching it back because you gotta apply this today. Okay, if you're not saying only today, right now, all your neighbors. Okay, you are missing out on some people that could be potential yeses. And if you just do this all day long and you just get one more, that's one more sale a day times 6 days in the week, that's an extra 6 sales. Who would appreciate another 6 sales on our check?
Sheesh.
And you just by doing this, you increase your paycheck by 30%. Some of us 100. Who would appreciate, I'm telling you how to get a pay increase. And some of us would be like, no, I got it. Someone's gonna be like, Danny doesn't know what he's talking about. Okay, you're right, I probably don't, but I do. Okay, so agree to disagree. Make sense?
Makes sense.
Guys, who can use Fuji 5 times in the pitch? Every time.